This is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com. Today I have another exciting episode for you, and I'm coming at you from my front yard garden. I just got done planting out, I don't know, man, probably like about 100 pepper plants in each bed. I spaced them probably about 12 inches apart. We got 60 in this one, and probably another 40 in that one at least. So over 100 pepper plants. Now I know what you might be thinking. You know, I know it's getting a little dark, but you can still see the color on these guys. They're not nice and dark green. They're like a little bit yellow, and you'd be going, John, what's going on, man? What's going on to your plants? Well, you know, this is what happened to my plants. I got some of these pepper plants for free, actually, because I rescued them, and I need to nurse these guys back to health. And this is how they look like. I mean, I got them like this. They're kind of shriveled and yellowed, and this may happen if you overwater, underwater, or the plants are stressed out for some reason, or maybe they just don't have enough nutrition in the soil for their stage of growth. I don't exactly know what happened, but I took them, and you know, there's been plenty of times when I've taken plants that look like in this condition, and I nursed them back to health. And you know, I always recommend you guys just get healthy plants in the first place. It's always easier and better, but you know, I like a good challenge, especially when it comes to gardening. So I got some of these guys for free, and we're gonna see if we could bring them back to health, because a plant is a terrible thing to waste. All right, So once we got all this planted, you know, I watered them in. You know, I watered before I transplanted, then watered them in after I got them into the ground. And the next thing we're going to do is I'm going to actually add some supplemental fertilizer or nutrients. Now, for those of you guys that have seen my show before, you guys know that, you know, I'm big on actually not doing supplemental feeding only when necessary. Now, this is a case when it is necessary. You might be thinking, John, if you don't use any supplemental fertilizer, like, you know, some gardening methods want you to fertilize like every week, you know, I don't got the time to fertilize every week. I travel, I do all kinds of stuff. I don't have to remember to like fertilize my garden, because if you miss it, you know, your plants might not do well. You know, I want to use the smart and, you know, prudent approach. And to me, what that is actually building good soil. And if you build good soil and you have microbes, including bacteria, fungi, nematodes, and protozoa. So by building good soil, basically you could have your soil make enough nutrition, including nitrogen and all the other nutrients that your plants need by themselves. Because what happens is one thing eats another thing, which eats another thing, and then another thing, and then the worms eat all that, and then they poop out, and the worms make worm castings, and along the chain, each thing eating the other thing is pooping out nutrients, and those are nutrients that are bioavailable to your plants. So that's my style of gardening. I don't actually advocate supplemental feeding unless when necessary, such as this situation when, you know, the transplants didn't have enough nutrition. Now that they're in the ground, they will get enough nutrition, but I want them to recover quickly from the transplant shot, plus also the nutrient deficiency that they probably had when they were still in the container or the stress they were going under. So what we're going to use today and what I would normally use is, you know, depending on two things. Sometimes I'll use some kelp extract or kelp, you know, spray, foliar feed, and actually soil drench, and I'll use that stuff, and that's one option I have. But sometimes if it's like in a more extreme case, then I'll use the fish emulsion. So we have some standard fish type emulsion here. This is called the fish mix, and this is OMRI listed, so it can be used in organic agriculture. Whenever buying any fertilizer, I encourage you guys to make sure it is OMRI listed so that it can be used in organic agriculture, because, you know, even things that say fish and whatnot could have a lot of things that I wouldn't want to put in my garden, let's just put it that way. That being said, fish emulsion, I want you guys to be aware, is like the basically the leftovers from different food processing industries, and it's basically the bottom of the barrel. Whatever's left just gets turned into fish emulsion with basically careless disregard for what's in there. The other thing is that, you know, because the fish was processed in whatever way, it may not have as much nutrition if it's processed in a very specific way. So that being said, what we're gonna do today is actually talk to you guys about the best fish fertilizer to use on your plants, and it's a new product that just came out. Here we have two different kinds. Actually, they're the same thing, just different packages. One's actually called the Organic Nutrients Ocean Grown Soluble Protein Codfish Hydrolysate for use in all phases of growth. This one, basically the same thing from what I've told, is pure protein dry made from codfish hydrolysate. So, you know, why this is different than this guy here is because of the processing. They specifically use codfish on these guys, and they basically, after they use the cod to make fish sticks or whatever, they take the frames, which is the bone and all the you know, leftover meat and all the other stuff on the fish. And they actually put that through a special enzymatic process at low temperatures. So what this does, the enzymes break down the proteins that are in the fish, and then it breaks it into amino acids. And I'm going to stop there for a second. You know, when you guys eat food, like you eat cows or fish or chickens for the protein, because we think we need the protein, because, oh yeah, you need protein to be big and strong, right? We don't actually need the protein. What we need is the amino acids that are actually the building blocks of the protein. So if we eat chicken, fish, cow, whatever, we get the protein, then our body has to now, at low temperature, break these proteins down into the amino acid components. And then once we got the amino acids, then our bodies get to perform our own proteins that we need. So we're absorbing the protein secondhand where we're eating, you know, animal products like that. And that's why I like to eat fruits and vegetables, and especially the leafy greens. Leafy greens are high in the amino acids so that our body could actually reduce the whole breakdown process so we could have better energy, more nutrition, and more importantly, the phytochemicals and phytonutrients that come along with a protein. Because in my opinion, far more important than the protein are the phytochemicals and phytonutrients that are in all the plant foods that you see growing behind me. So, let's fast forward back into the plant. So basically, the fish hydrolysate has been broken down into the amino acid components for you, and now the amino acids can be directly absorbed by the plants, much like we absorb the amino acids from the plant foods, and then we build the proteins. This is in a way that the plants could get the best utilization out of this. This is also rich in nitrogen, and it's a non-leaching nitrogen. So the way this is processed, it basically gives you nitrogen that's not gonna have residual buildup. I mean, excess buildup of nitrogen in your soil is actually really bad thing, because it's gonna just basically run off, run into the groundwater, run into the Gulf of Mexico, and create dead zones and all this crazy stuff. So this product will not do that. Once again, this is also OMRI listed, so this is considered organic, but no, it's not vegan. So the thing is, you know, this to me, I like to add only when possible to, you know, get my plants healthy, because I like to use a natural system, a biologic system, for the soil to make its own nutrients so that I don't have to continually spray and feed my plants. That being said, if you want extra production and all this kind of stuff, you could use this more regularly than I do. I just don't personally believe in it, because actually this stuff can be expensive, and even worse than expensive, once you guys open this jar up, and actually this comes sealed in a jar, and then also in a plastic bag that's actually been opened. As you can see, it's dusting off there. Ugh. This is why I don't like this stuff. Do you smell it? Oh man, it smells like rotten fish. It smells so terrible. So I'm not a huge fan of this stuff, but I'll spray it when my plants are in need, because I don't want to lose my plants, and I do want them to bring them back to life. So yes, doesn't smell the best. The other thing is that this is very attractive to some dogs. So don't leave this out where your dog could find it. They might break into the package and eat it, because basically, after all, it's just the amino acids from fish, and it smells like fish. So if it smells like fish, it tastes like fish, but I'm not eating it. That being said, for people that are into plant-based eating and don't want to spray fish on their foods, there are actually soy-based amino acids as well. The main difference between the soy-based amino acid and this, the fish-based amino acid, is one amino acid actually called tryptophan. And from what I hear, it doesn't work as well as this stuff. But nonetheless, it is available for those that, you know, want to, you know, do a plant-based amino acid solution. Now, the thing is, to spray this stuff on, it is soluble. So that's another thing that's really cool. Can be used in hydroponics, unlike the standard fish emulsions. What you're going to do, and I'm dripping it everywhere is here. What you're going to do is you're going to have to basically put it into a water solution and then basically spray it on or water it on. Woo, man, this stuff smells so terrible. This is why I don't like it. So while you could put this in like a pump sprayer and spray it on, or you could just mix it up and then, you know, put in a watering can of water. Man, this stuff smells so bad. I really don't like it. Ooh, I got to get this. Oh, it's all over my skin. Probably smell like fish for days, and that's not because my hands were down there somewhere on my girlfriend that I don't have. So what we're going to use today is we're going to use a chameleon sprayer to spray this out at the right proportion. I really like this chameleon sprayer because it will basically take any liquid substance And then it has this little dial here, and you could set it to, like, you know, how many teaspoons to dilute per gallon, and it's fairly accurate, actually. And we're actually going to set it to 2 tablespoons per gallon. All right, there it is, 2 tablespoons per gallon. We're going to go ahead and twist this guy off. And how this works is you're just going to hook in your hose right here. It's really cool because it also has a quick disconnect right there. So nice and easy and convenient. And then basically you could rotate this to the different sprayer nozzles. It has a little circle, a little like rain fan, and then a little spray. So we're going to go ahead and put it on the rain fan there. And what we're going to do is we're going to take some of the powder here. And it's kind of cool. We don't really have to measure this because it's going to be measured as it comes out. I'm just going to put a bunch in there. And I'm going to take my standard hose and we're going to add some water to the mixture. We're going to put the top on. And we're going to shake it up. Shake it up. Wait, wasn't that a car song? Shake it up. Alright, so we got this all soluble. It's all filled in there. What we're going to do now is go ahead and take the end of my hose here that I have a off and on ball valve right here. So that for just such an occasion, I could actually remove my hose sprayer. We're going to then take the chameleon and just screw this in. I like screwing things in. Wait, I like screwing things in more than I like screwing things off. All right, so we're screwing this in. Just like that. And now that we're set on 2 tablespoons per gallon, all we simply need to do, turn this on. And all we need to do now is spray on my peppers. So I'm going to go ahead and water all my peppers. I'm going to foliar feed it and also do a root drench with this guy right here. Whew, man, that stinks. And I'm doing it at the end of the day so I could go inside after this and I don't have to smell it anymore and hopefully wash it off my hands as well. Now, this can be foliar applied. It can also be root drenched. It can also be put in hydroponics because, once again, it is water soluble. It can be added to your compost tea and they'll actually make the bacteria and fungi go nuts, which will increase your food soil web. So, I mean, I think the pure protein all around is definitely a good product to use. That being said, I'm only going to use it as needed. I'm not going to apply it all the time by no means because I got better things to do than smell stinky fish because I don't normally have to smell fish. And maybe next time I'll use the kelp instead. But I wanted really to show this to you guys, to give you guys options. And that's what my show is about. I want to give you guys options. Whether you want to use it like I do in extreme emergencies like this, or whether you want to use it more often and get better results, you know, that's up to you guys. But I always want to show you guys the latest and greatest products that will allow you to grow better and healthier crops more naturally and organic so that you and your family could eat healthier and, you know, save the planet one person at a time. If you guys are interested in buying some of the pure protein powders, please check the links below the video. I have negotiated special discounted Growing Your Greens discounted pricing for you guys. That's going to be below to get the special pricing. Just click on that link and follow the directions, and you'll get some of the stuff to rescue your plants if they have some transplant shock or, you know, yellow up like mine did. And I'll be sure to give you guys an update in a future episode to show you guys how my peppers are doing. So hope you guys enjoyed this episode learning more about the codfish fish hydrolysate. Better than fish emulsion, better than any other fish fertilizer that I ever found. Once again, my name is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. We'll see you next time, and remember, keep on growing.